you when there was the cold bright dawn. It's 7 o'clock on a Monday morning. Pour a cup of coffee, better make it a strong one. Where the man on the radio says it's gonna rain and it's gonna blow. It'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. Australia marched out of Vietnam, out in the streets against Uncle Sam, and we won the fight. It was a long one. Uranium demo the other day, one of my mates got dragged away.
Against the famine of another, and hope was in the fast lane riding home. They were roaring from their buildings, which were monuments to greed and fear and the science and the logic that had failed. And minds were merely silicon. The aimless world had power to grasp the thunder and to dash it to the ground. We were slow to come to anger, as we were slow to understand. And we groped for words that might contain the rage. And naked, terror faded into shadows of despair. Still we fought the rising madness of our age. We marched in tens of thousands, while the cynics printed curses, cause as usual, they'd seen it all before. And our freedom left us nothing but to turn to face the tyranny of silence, lest it blow away the dawn.
shelters were those who faced the judgment of a pale and tragic sun upon our faces. The crumbling ruins, the acid rain, the dull and dreary waiting, the sickness and the anger and the pain. The broken black holes once so proud lay scattered on the cars and homes, friends of ours who didn't even know. Now memories closed upon a world that didn't see the morning, and a cold wind blew to the corners of our souls.
Getting up to anything this weekend?
Well, tomorrow we'll probably go for a swim before...
When Corinne and Roxanne first thought of their business idea, special treats your dog can eat, they decided...
On the battlefield across the sea, one wet and dismal morn, a heritage was carved in blood and a fighting man was born. The rugged slopes of Gallipoli, where the digger earned his name, and the admiration of the Turk, Australia is his name. With a careless grin across his lips and a rifle in his hand, he's fought his way throughout the years in jungle or in sand, and proudly wearing on his head the hat they wore to fame. In the blooded test of courage raw, Australia is his name. He's a fighting man of world renown and a cobber of the best. Just like his dad did once before, he's passed in every test. Now once again the drums of war have found him just the same. With the side turned up on this old hat, Australia is his name. There's a mother sits at home and waits in a thousand different towns, but down inside she's full of pride, her boy won't let her down. For he was born the digger breed, and he'll carry on the name. In the blooded test of courage raw, Australia is his name. Battlefields across the sea, one wet and dismal morn, a heritage was carved in blood and a fighting man was born. On the rugged slopes of Gallipoli, where the digger earned his name, and the admiration of the Turk, Australia is his name. And the admiration of the Turk, Australia is his name.
Frost from the loins city folk today, and they couldn't tell shit from clay. A ripening crop of Stovey poles, there's no regrets when the memory rhymes that earth is in me bones. He did his bit in the First World War, took a shilling to fight the Hun, but up to his crotch in Flanders fields and the gas eating at his lungs. His best mate died hanging on the barbed wire, and when the attack was through, we took some prisoners to HQ, shared a bag and a yarn or two. They were the same as me and you. And I asked our dead what history meant as he sharpened his edging shears. What a bloody fool question that is, my boy, I've lived it for 83 years. Hotel. He'd laugh with his mates, go teasing forth. Where he went, even he couldn't tell. He said, King and country, cock and bull, we fought just to survive. The anger might have faded, still this feeling grabs me deep inside. I guess you could call it pride. There's a navvy on the line in the Nullarbor, depression left its scars. Heaving cold steel rails in the burning sun, freezing beneath the stars. He said, if you escaped the Sussokers, you had a hell of a price to pay. And when time flowed like an open wound, I'd blow me dough on a Saturday, drink the pain away. And I asked old Ted what history meant as he sharpened his edging shears. What a bloody fool question that is, my boy, I've lived it for 83 years. Sunday arvo, we'd sit and talk over a dozen cold West End. But what was gained and what was lost and would never come again. He said, money you know, it comes and goes on booze and rent and fags. You can make a fortune on overtime and lose it all on the nags. But years of toil with a bunch of mates, you know, it leaves you satisfied. Though we never moved a mountain, we sure gave it a try. Pick the wheat from the chaff and the steel from the skirt and the honest man from a liar. If wisdom came by other names, tend to the fire. And on the day that old Ted died, no one would have known. In a pauper's grave, he lived and died alone. And the 727 trod overhead with a drone of the angry rose. They seemed to pause for just a while, and the silence was heard around 4 miles. And the silence was heard for miles.
Spoke no English, but he had a dream, and he saved up most of his pay to bring his wife and 6 kids from Lebanon and settle.